able to get the data from the drone. There. Now I can reconnect it with the dome back at the base. Full of rebels. Time to find whoever's in charge and take them out. This easy?
Blade is sharp. My eyes are open. Sign of the enemy.
Too many whiners in the ranks. They need discipline.
You better have my back.
There's nothing to worry about.
All
my
clear?
Fault. Don't know what got into me.
Orders say we check everything, so we check.
I must be the leader of this outpost. They seem to have the best gear.
I'm not alone here.
suspicious.
Eyes up. This probably isn't over. I thought
stay alert. Maybe.
This is another excuse to ditch your duties again. Opportunity. Don't come back. Think this is a game, Outlander? Just you wait.
These rebels won't be bothering anyone else. My fall. They've been salvaging machine parts. Raptors. Looks like they've been struck for parts. I should check if there's anything with a lock around here. Then I can open that chest with this key I found. Some tags here. I should take them to Duca. Stripping corruptors for parts. That can't be good. stash when I need it. Not easy to take down. I can catch my breath here. It'll make an interesting color for my armor. An Utaru shrine. I'm not sure what it means. Overhead scrappers now. Turn one against the others. Good time to pull out shock ammo. use its tail to shoot at me if I break it first. She's on to me. Careful not to let this stain my hands. There's wrecks scattered all across this mountain. It would work well in armor. This will make a good die. Back in that way. Looks like Zoe started a garden out here.
says here it had bubbles in it?
Well, we can't expect to make sense out of everything the old ones did.
Welcome back.
Hey, Gaia. Me again.
Welcome back, Aloy. Where shall we resume?
So I talked to Beta. Didn't learn much.
It seems to me you did. From what she describes, the Zeniths controlled every aspect of her life, even as they shunned her. This Tilda was the first person she ever had contact with. An abrupt severance of such a relationship would be very emotionally damaging.
Yeah, I guess you're right. The Zeniths. Gerard, Eric, Tilda, Verbena. Beta said they were some of the most powerful people on Earth. I think Elizabeth knew one of them. Tilda. Did she ever mention her to you?
No. Elizabeth often spoke of her work, or told stories of her mother and her childhood. If she knew this Tilda, she did not disclose it with me. What we can conclude from your and Beta's experiences is that the Zeniths are ruthless in pursuit of their goal. To protect life on Earth, they must be stopped.
I'll be off.
Farewell, for now.
Okay, data module's in. Hey, Gaia. It's me.
Hello, Aloy. Did you wish to continue our discussion?
So I guess this room was meant to keep an eye on conditions outside?
Yes. From here, the facility's operators would have been able to observe weather and machine activity in real time. It may be possible to restore more of this room's functionality should you find and reconnect additional camera feeds.
I'll keep a lookout. I should be-
Goodbye.
The old ones used holograms for everything.
It let them experience a great many things.
Holograms are amazing. I wonder if at some point they just couldn't tell what was real anymore.
Maybe. They were intelligent, but that doesn't mean they were wise.
It's like some kind of maintenance space. I wonder where this leads.
Aloy? A bunch of lights just turned on up here? Was that you?
Oh. Huh. Yeah, I guess it was. Just wanted to see how you're doing.
I'm fine.
Because the last time we spoke about Tilda, you got pretty upset, so I...
Forget it. Was there anything else?
So have you been upstairs at all?
Not really.
Varl sometimes comes down here to talk.
He keeps asking if I'm okay. I thought he only wanted to know about my productivity, but... It's almost like he actually wants to talk to me.
Yeah, I think he does. Have you talked with anyone else in the base?
I speak with Gaia.
She asked me how I'm feeling and my opinion on various topics. I didn't expect that from an AI.
That's all thanks to Elizabeth. She believed Gaia had to care, not just follow her programming orders.
I know. Independent emotional processing enabled the previous version of Gaia to create you, after all.
Yeah. I guess so. What else can you tell me about Tilda?
She liked to talk about her paintings.
What about herself? Did she ever talk about her life on Earth, how she joined the Zeniths, something like that?
She never said much about herself, and she hated it when I asked too many questions. But I think back on Earth, she was an expert programmer, given that she built a data channel the other Zeniths couldn't detect.
Is there anything else about her that we might be able to use to our advantage?
She was the first real person who ever bothered to speak to me. I wasn't really assessing her for strengths and weaknesses.
You said Tilda showed you paintings and let you access media files?
Every time we met, she showed me a new painting. I think she was Dutch. All of her favorite pieces were from their golden age in the 1600s. Portraits, allegories, ships at sea. She had so many.
That didn't interest you?
I liked her media portal. It had so much more than my training interface. Clips, shows, holos. My favorite was this one called Second Time Around, about a family whose kid comes back after disappearing during the Hot Zone crisis.
Right, but did this portal have anything about the Zeniths themselves? Anything we could use?
No. Any information about them was redacted.
So have you been able to make use of your expertise?
I guess so. Gaia transferred a lot of data on Hephaestus to study.
And? Any insights?
It looks like it's been modifying its code, increasing in size and complexity over the years. There's a lot to analyze still.
Okay, well, keep at it, I guess. It's time for me to go. I'll check on you later.
Yeah, sure.
Why is the store locked now?
Beta requested the use of that room as her personal space. I have locked it at her request.
Okay. Beta's been difficult to figure out. She's just so closed off. I get that the Zeniths were cruel to her, that the one called Tilda abandoned her, but I can't get her out of her shell. I don't know. Maybe nothing can. I know Varl meant well bringing up Rost. I guess it's hard to talk about. With everything going on, it feels easier to set those memories aside. At least for now. Looks like I can open that door now.
What?
Nothing. You just look good, that's all.
Get back to study.
There's a lot of equipment in here. Gaia, what was all this for?
This room was designed for management of the facility's vast seed banks. From here, control center operatives would have monitored new crop rotations into the automated farmlands, now known as Plainsong.
I see. According to this console, there are still thousands of plant samples stored deep below the facility. I could ask Gaia about them the next time I talk to her. Mind if we have a word?
Of course not.
What do you think of this place? It must take some getting used to.
It's an efficient center of operations, and an acceptable training facility. Though it could use some more color.
Duly noted. Anything else you've been looking at with that focus?
Gaia showed me the knowledge you recovered out in the desert. I am no chaplain, but I'd be curious to test if something I read is true.
What is it?
The old ones believed one could hear the great waters, even in the middle of the desert, if you carried the carcass of a water animal with you. They called them seashells.
That sounds kind of gross. Have you spoken with Erend at all?
I've had little chance to. I did see him bring some ale from out east.
That stuff's as bitter as salvebrush.
You get used to it, eventually. In fact, I wouldn't mind a drink myself.
I'm sure Erend wouldn't mind sharing. I should get going.
If I can help in some way, say the word.
I will. Thank you. There's data here. Another room. What for?
The world is in peril, and we fight amongst ourselves.
Plugging in that power cell downstairs must have turned on these holograms.
Maybe we can look at it together later. Have a conversation about it.
I'd like that.
Now, this file's crazy. Why would anyone use oils for that?
Aloy, it's good to see you.
Just thought I'd check in. How's training?
Discovering something new about our past every day. When we first met, you asked me if I ever wondered what this world looked like when the old ones lived here. I thought it was strange at the time, but a lot has changed since I left the Embrace. Now I'm just trying to make sense of everything I thought I knew and versus everything I know now.
The change is hard, but it gets easier over time. You feeling okay?
I was just thinking about Beta and all that time spent with the Zeniths. To think someone would make a person just to lock them in a room to use when needed, like some sort of tool. Elizabeth Sobeck sacrificed herself for the world, and yet they have no trouble treating Beta like a slave.
Another reason we have to stop them. I'm guessing Talana didn't stay for long?
You got that right. Makes you wonder what this Amadis guy did to grab her attention.
Whatever it was, she didn't tell me.
Must be quite a story.
I guess she'll tell us when she's ready. You brought up Rost before. I do think about him. You know, he was all I had. And he brought me up the best he could. Not only that, when Hades discovered who I was and sent the Eclipse after me, he sacrificed himself so I could survive. But that seems like ages ago. So much has happened since. What I'm doing now, I don't think he could even begin to understand it. The Sacred Lands were all he really knew. So I can't let myself dwell on him. Not with everything I have to do.
I understand. Sometimes, when I think about my sister, about what she would have become if she had survived the proving, it hurts. And I just need to bury it for a while. But only for a while, Aloy. You can't ignore it forever. Memories always come back. The ones that matter, anyway.
I know. But for now, the mission has to come first.
Fair enough.
It's hard to believe we're dealing with the original Zeniths. The same ones that left for Sirius 1,000 years ago.
To live on for so long, it doesn't seem natural.
Because it's not.
That weapon we found where Beta was hiding, any chance we can use that against them?
Sylens made sure that wasn't an option.
Why would he build something to hurt Far Zenith, yet allow them to capture you?
With Sylens, there's always an angle. We just don't know what it is yet. What do you make of this Tilda the Beta was talking about?
Well, the way she described it, I can't shake off the feeling that Tilda wanted something from Beta. Maybe because she's Elizabeth Sobeck's clone? But whatever she wanted, I don't think she got it. If we knew what it was, maybe we could use it to our advantage somehow.
I don't know. I don't think Tilda and Elizabeth were on the best of terms.
Oh well. At least we can take some comfort in knowing the Zeniths don't trust each other.
Maybe. I should get back out there.
We'll be here if you need us.
Aloy.
Hey, how's everything going?
I am well, but Varl told me Beta's having a hard time adjusting to life here with us. I wish there was something I could do to help.
I'm not sure any of us can.
A tree won't bear fruit in a day. We'll do our best to make her feel welcome.
What are you going to learn next?
I'm not sure. I asked Gaia for suggestions, and she brought up data you found on something called a museum? From what I gather, The Old Ones would store knowledge in them for all to see and learn from, like you've done here for us. Maybe one day more people will be able to use this place to learn the way we have.
That sounds crowded, but nice. Varl looks pretty focused.
He's been obsessing over the data revealed to us by Poseidon. Just the other day, we read about mountains hiding deep underwater that spew fire. If I understand correctly, Gaia said the flames they release come from the very center of the Earth, like a heart beating with the life of the world. As always, the cycle can be found in even the most unlikely of places. Of course, Varl's mostly interested in watching explosions happen underwater.
Is there anything I can help with around here?
Oh, no. We're doing fine.
Are you okay?
You and Varl have been friends for a while.
I like to think so.
I was wondering, what do you know about his mother?
Oh.
That bad, huh?
Why do you want to know?
He's spoken of his sister, Vala, but I noticed he avoids talking about his mother.
She's the war chief of the Nora. Best warrior the tribe's ever known. Tougher than a thunderjaw, but she could be pretty harsh at times.
I see. That must have been hard on him. Thank you for telling me. I feel silly not being able to ask Varl directly.
I wouldn't worry about it. He's probably afraid Sona will scare you off someday.
I'd like to see her try.
The Zeniths did a number on Beta. But she seems to trust Varl.
I still can't believe she told him the Zeniths are immortals. Old ones who cut themselves off from the cycle of life and decay. I've never heard of anything so selfish. To deny our dying bodies to the Earth. To doom the life that would bloom in their place. It's despicable.
I should get going.
Good luck on your search.
Talana must have left this for me on her way back east. I wish she could have stayed. But I know Meridian and the Lodge need her.
I wouldn't have taught you the song if I didn't like the way you sing it.
So you like hearing me butcher Utaru?
I sure don't. You sound like a dying lawn leg.
Is this a piece from the Bulwark? Catalo must have brought this with him as a trophy. I may have fired the cannon, but he really put Dakote in his place.
So the Old Ones liked painting tiny soldiers?
One of Studius Wadis's many scrolls. It was a pain getting him to Baronlight. Still, he didn't deserve to be run down by Regala's riders. This must be from the Cool Root. Between the Rockbreaker and the Slitherfang, Regala really wrecked the arena. And I have a feeling she won't stop trying until Hikaru's dead.
Yes.
I see you, champion. Sit, please. You should know the rebels have been busy. They've set up outposts to the west. Some settled into a camp southwest of here. And I know the marshals can't deal with all of them, so I'd stay alert out there if I were you.
Thanks for the warning. Getting rid of those outposts might stop the rebels from killing more of their own. Maybe I can lend the marshals a hand.